What's your favorite movie?
First thing to buy when you want to upgrade your life, a blender. Don't buy spring water, it's dirty.
Ring, 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 ring.
It's from a dirty spring.
Ring, ring, ring.
Sprung out of the dirty ground.
Ring, 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 for the next month.
Run over a dirty mountain.
Ugh, grates on my nerves.
Minerals, I've got minerals.
Look how much I can squish it.
Hold my balls while I'm jogging along.
Jiggle bells, jiggle bells.
Life changing.
All the way.
Hey.
It's new shoes, new shoes.
Something I wanted to do with the hammock. There's hooks. The hook.
A good feeling about this.
Yeah.
I speak five languages, dude.
Five languages?
Yeah.
It's amazing. I speak one.
Say yes to everything.
Say yes to everything.
Trash and wait, get it back out of the trash.
Yeah. All right. Before, after. That's about 500 miles there, ladies and gentle monkeys. I think this is the most amazing part. I've gone right down to the red. Look how much is gone. That's shocking. I've worn away about an inch.
Hey, come and say hello. Hey, buddy. Hello, friend.
You gonna help me pack? Maybe we can squish you in here. Can we squish you in this? Can we squish you inside? I really feel a sense of... Oops. Alrighty then. I really feel a sense of, like... remorse. What's that word? Where you're mourning. Like I'm losing a friend. Like these are my shoes that got me from Miami to here, and I'm like trying to put them in the trash, but every part of me wants to keep them as like a museum, a souvenir. To keep all my shoes that I've used would be amazing. And I'm so tempted to keep them, mail them home. I'll take some pictures and keep the pictures. But you've done me good, Hokers. Hoka 1-1. Tough shoes. Designed for ultra marathon distance. And I've literally worn through. If I put my finger in here, I can feel there's about half a centimeter before I would have literally worn a hole through to the ground. So, with much remorse and a fond farewell, I love you, and goodbye.
Be strong.
Done me proud.
Goodbye, my love.
It's difficult to walk away.
Just go.
Wait. Shh.
Just go.
I would love to keep all the pairs of shoes and have them like racked up one day, like a, on,
yeah,
you
know.
That's what I was saying, like, I consider it.
So why not? Send them back home. Look, yeah. I need new shoes too. I've got a hole in it.
I just wore black socks.
Oh, yeah?
I can't tell as much.
Yeah. That's a good move. Yeah, I considered
right,
it. If I send them all to Dan, then if I fly home from Dan sometime, I could take them all in my luggage.
Yeah.
It's tempting. It would be cheap.
Not too late. Get them back out of the trash.
Yeah. All right. I'm going to keep them. Yay! Something in my heart is like, that's not right. What is this? Oh. He doesn't like eating them.
He doesn't like eating treats in general. It takes him a really long time. He just looks at them for a while and eventually eats them. He's like, I can't eat while you're recording me.
Everybody's watching. Look. You want some? You want some? Nice.
Yeah.
He's gonna spit back up. That's what he does.
I'm gonna eat this one up. Nom nom nom.
There you go. Don't taste good. This is how he eats every treat. It's not just the medicine. Moti's sitting here looking at him. He wants it so bad.
You want? I think because in their natural habitat, they're all like competing for food.
Yeah.
So it helps to be like, hey, I'm going to eat it if you don't eat it.
Okay, now you can go.
I really feel good about this idea to keep all the shoes. It's, I know it's silly and it's strange and it's unnecessary. Mail them to Dan. Dan's gonna have to store all of my old shoes until I eventually fly them home or mail them home. That feels better to me than to just chuck them in the trash and not have the museum. It's a silly expense, but to me, it's well worth it. It was with a heavy, heavy heart that I dropped them in the trash and it just felt wrong. So I'm very thankful to Holly that she was like, well, just keep them then.
Are you helping me to pack? Yeah.
That's an underquilt.
You can't go in there. That's an underquilt. Buddy.
My shoes.
Wait, could I get broccoli instead of meat?
Like the broccoli, do you want no meat at all?
Yeah.
And you can get one more veggie on top of it.
Yeah, yeah. So then cauliflower?
Say tomatoes.
Okay.
Tomatoes at the back there near you. Yeah.
Fresh kitchen with the bellow.
Hey.
He's like, I want to take you to this fast food healthy place.
Very good. Life changing. This food is about to change his life.
I'm like, yeah. I say yeah to everything.
So how did your English get so good? Because you
know, speak five languages, dude.
Five languages?
Yeah.
It's amazing. I speak one. This is it now.
Yeah,
do you dream in different languages?
You know what, champ? Actually, I dream in English now.
In English?
If I'm in Lesotho, I dream in Sotho. I'm around Sotho people.
Yeah.
And if I'm in South Africa and I'm around Afrikaans people, I dream in Afrikaans.
Right. And so it's whatever you're most recently exposed to.
Exactly. You know, like the people that will be around me.
Mm-hmm.
Like if I'm in Lesotho, people can understand. Like some people can. I can't be speaking English to them.
Yeah.
So I'll be dreaming in Lesotho, you know what I mean? But since I've been in America for like so long now, I guess everybody, I just always dream in English now.
Yeah, you seem like an American, but with a slightly African accent, kind of. It's interesting.
Yeah, I know.
Like, you're like this cool dude, like, yeah, man, cool. But it's got this, like, African kind of accent.
I've adapted well, I would say. Adaptation.
In my mind, I'm making a movie, so it's all going to kind of edit down.
Yeah. I'm interested to see like a full thing at the end, running around the world.
Yeah.
Like, what do you mean? Like, it's like you just call you full places and he just runs, you know, and he's just living his best life, you know, and you couch surfing him basically. It's like, wow, that's quite fascinating. And then I was like, yeah. He said he got his inspiration from Forrest Gump. And I'm like, wait, yeah, everybody knows it.
Yeah.
Like, you don't know it? I was like, I know. Bella, are you serious, man?
Even Holly was convinced, oh, he must have seen it, he just doesn't remember the name.
Yeah.
She was like, no, he probably has seen it, he just doesn't.
I hope I have seen it and I don't know the name. That's why I'm like, I'm excited for you to show me that.
I figured since they're around this far, maybe I just run across the great state of Alabama. And that's what I did. I ran clear across Alabama. No particular reason, I just kept on going. I ran clear the ocean.
I How did you see the movie? Were you just like, I didn't see
it? It came out about the time when I was in school, and it was famous, and it won lots of awards and stuff, so it's like everybody watched it.
When I got to another ocean, I figured since I've gone this far, I might as well just turn back, keep right on going. When I got tired, I slept. When I got hungry, I ate. When I had to go, you know, I went.
And so, you just ran.
Yeah.
Kind of like Titanic or something.
Oh, really?
Like, everybody's seen Titanic.
Yeah, everybody's seen the Titanic, yeah.
But there was a girl who made me laugh once. They it was like a questionnaire, kind of like fast questions, like okay. Pop quiz. And they were like, where were you when you first saw Titanic? And she was like, I never seen it. And they were like, what do you mean? You've never seen Titanic? And she said, I'm not that fond of boats. She's, like, she's like, I'm not that interested in boats.
That's hilarious.
No, if I had to pick just one, I think it would have to be Dumb and Dumber, which is like
oh,
a funny.
Oh my word, that is so funny.
It's like
that,
a stupid
what's this
movie.
Guy's name?
Jim Carrey.
Jim Carrey, he is yeah. Hilarious. I like to have a drink with Jim Carrey.
Yeah. Like I know all the words, you know, for Dumb and Dumber.
Yeah.
Like I say a lot of the quotes.
We got no food, we got no jobs, our pets' heads are falling off!
It makes me laugh. Like more every time I watch it. It doesn't get old.
Mm-hmm.
2006.
It's crazy.
And I ate a lot of eggs in the beginning, and then eventually I was like,
why?
Maybe I don't need eggs.
Yeah.
You should run by my house. We're gonna fill the pool with ice.
Ice therapy.
On the big screen.
Just act a certain way online, and then they're completely different in person. And
cold, invigorating.
These guys are so cool, all of them.
Yeah, have no idea where to point the camera.
Good morning, ladies and gentlemen, monkeys. Jingle bells, jingle bells. Jiggling all the way. I'm checking the jiggle factor. Jiggle bells, jiggle bells. Do I jiggle all the way? Freshly packed belt with all my warm gear. Except for the big jacket. Just want to give it a test run. And also the new shoes, new shoes, new shoes. Gonna go to a little park that I found. Around the corner, I haven't shown you it yet. I'm gonna show you it now. It's the Amanita muscaria, fly agaric, Santa mushroom bench. The belt feels good, doesn't feel that heavy. I mean, I've only done, you know, a small distance, but I can normally tell if it's like heavy and cutting off the blood. It's not doing that. So, park it there for now. Park it like it's hot. Here's the park. So, pull-ups. Hi, good morning. Woof. Ah. Oh,
let's go running.
Yeah.
I did what I had to do in order to make the dream work. I made the commitment, knowing that it always wasn't going to be a smooth ride. But I felt like my only two choices was to either make it or not.
Mm.
And the not wasn't an option. Always, you always have to have a boundary. You always have to have a boundary of what you will or will not do. Now, your boundary is different from my boundary. At the same time, you have to live with yourself at the end of the day.
You know, it's like any commitment. You got to work on the passion too. You got to work to keep, bring the passion back.
You know, I have the same pressures as anyone else. There's time, there's performance, there's financial. I mean, there, you know, there's deadlines. My pressures are not unique. The situations may be different.
Most of you lack the skills to sell your vision with clarity because you don't practice. And if you don't believe with all your heart, then you're not gonna, you know, go that extra mile. And look for something that you can passionately believe in. Is that so difficult?
Believe in what you're going to do.
The strongest force in the human personality is the need to remain consistent with how we define ourselves. So we have the power to change what things mean to us and therefore what we feel in our body about them. But I think God gives you choices. And I believe your decisions are what shape your destiny.
Workout complete. I feel sore from last time. So this is just kind of loosening up or adding to the soreness. I'm not entirely sure. So while I've got my belt here, there's something I wanted to do with the hammock, which is figure out a way of hanging the belt inside the hammock. So it's protected from the rain if it rains, because it'll be naturally under the shelter. Also, it's inside the bug net, so bugs and creepy crawlies can't creep in there. And of course the dirt, if I put it down on the ground, it's not only susceptible to ants and bugs, but it's also gonna be picking up dirt, dust, maybe parasites and just shittiness, general shittiness down on the ground. So, even though I use a ground sheet, it's not ideal. I don't want my stuff touching the ground if possible. Another reason is, if I'm really, 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 really fast asleep and someone was to be very sneaky, they could whip the belt out from under me, as it were. So I do attach it to the hammock, but just by kind of a string. So again, if someone was sneaky enough with some scissors, they could just go snip and I'd wake up to no belt. So the ultimate solution is that I find a way to string it at one end of the hammock, preferably the end I'm going to put my feet at, problem I kind of expected. It's gonna make everything sag and take up too much space, but I have a cunning plan.
So it's Dutchware who designed these little fleas, and I think it could work, but right now it's not exactly quick release because the string is so long. I have to wrap it around and around and around the belt, snag it back on itself, and hold it back there. But the good news is, I think it could work. Never, ever, ever, ever in my life put an underquilt on or seen anyone else put an underquilt on, so I don't really know what I'm doing. But I guess it just dangles underneath and hooks on somehow. That was pretty simple. It's got all kinds of springy strings, and both the Dutchware hammock and the underquilt have hooks, and they hook to each other. See, there's hooks.
that hook, then this hook's up here. I guess I can adjust it if I'm at one end, if I'm not at this belt end and I'm more at that end or whatever, I can adjust it. So I've hooked it all on.
Wonderful if I could squish the hammock with the quilt attached and just leave it permanently attached. Otherwise I have to hook it on every single time I want to go to bed. The question is, will it fit in the belt when it's a hammock plus an underquilt? One way to find out. Definitely gonna be a bit more awkward to pack the hammock. It won't be quite so like fast. And that looks like a very, very long stuff sack, but maybe it will compress down. Whew. It's definitely a real squeeze to get it down the tube. But I have faith. I mean, it's in. It's a huge, long tube compared to the rest, but maybe it will squish. Rolling my sausage roll. Feel like I can clip it. Yeah, look at that. Can we get the chop on? Yeah. Now we should be able to compress it even more with the straps. Strap, strap. Oh, I got a good feeling about this. Yes. Look how much I can squish it. Look at the wrinkles. I've squashed. Squish, squish, squish. Now it doesn't even look all that out of place. It's like the same size. That's the basketball right there. That's the top of the basketball. That's the hammock. Yeah! Yeah! Brilliant. I'm so pleased with myself. Like, yes! So that means that my warm underquilt will be permanently attached all of winter. Success. That also means I've just saved space in a different pouch, which will be my sleeping bag pouch. And I've gained a Western mountaineering bag, which will be useful for something. You know, I don't know what I've put in there yet, but it'll come in handy. Those kind of stuff sacks, you know. They're very handy. I don't think it's waterproof, but it's useful for stuffing things. Beautiful. I'd say that was a very successful morning. Definitely can't wipe the smile off my face. I'm like warm, prepared for all weather. Doesn't feel too heavy, not even uncomfortable to construct or pack or... Yeah, I've achieved a lot this morning. Very, very happy. Jingle bells, jingle bells, jingle all the way. Yes! Thank you. Ultralight gear creators, You rock my world. We're gonna go now to awesome alterations ladies with the sewing machine. And we have sewn a thin layer of protection inside my shorts. We are open. Poop. I think I could do it myself, and then I thought, no, you're gonna be better than me. I'm hanging in my hammock. My shoes hang on the side. And it just ripped a very small bit here. So we just wanna make it very, very strong. Eddie's Custom Cleaners, alterations on site. On site! So, if you want any dry cleaning and you happen to be in Tampa, I recommend you go there. Lovely ladies. They even fixed one of my broken hammock bits for free. And I'll show you the shorts in close up. My North Face shorts. They're super light and they dry super quack. Super quack? Righty then. Here's my North Face shorts. They dry super fast. I think they're called flash dry. Yeah, it says it there, like flash dry. So they're amazing. They scrunch up really small. They're very, very easy to pack. However, I don't think they're really designed for running because this inside leg seam is serious chafing, especially that central point there is very abrasive. And then even on the front, I had this front seam rubbing on my knob, and that was causing all kinds of trouble. I literally had it bleeding at one point. I mean, it was bad. A little bit graphic, but it's true. So these shorts are just like pajamas. I just keep the red ones separate from the black ones. The black ones are the ones I run in. So we've kept the seam at the back. That's fine. But look what we've done here. We've put a little bit of this material over the chafe zone. See, it's this kind of material here. So it's very stretchy and not too abrasive. So there we go. Problem solved. There were times where my muscles didn't hurt that bad. The heat wasn't even that bad. You know, the hunger, the thirst, the whatever, the struggle was real, but I was coping. But the main thing that hurt was my inner thighs, you know? That's annoying to be, like, struggling because, like, there were times, without being too graphic, where I would have to hold my balls while I'm jogging along. It's for real. I even tried putting them in a sock, and that's that didn't work either. And it's not helping my thighs anyway. So then I'm straddling, like, walking really wide. I'm walking like this, trying to not have my thighs rubbed together. It's not a good way to go. Good. Merry every day. This guy out there just ringing a bell. It's got to be the most annoying job in the world. Hi. Ring, 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 ring. Like, how does that guy sleep at night? He must just be like, ring. Anyway, I'm doing some bonus miles to get distilled water. I decided it's a good test of the belt, and the tap water, of course, isn't really clean. And when possible, I like to make it a rule of mine to get distilled or reverse osmosis, pure, clean H2O. And I'll have to just carry it back with my muscles. First thing to buy when you want to upgrade your life, a blender. If you've already got the blender, next thing to buy is a water distiller. I recommend you go on Amazon or eBay or whatever, and you type in water distiller. Yeah, I think the best brand is Mega Home. I'm not sponsored by them or whatever. I've just had many a Mega Home in my life. I guess I'll just get two. One on each arm. And yeah, the Mega Homes, they last for years. I've seen them just go on and on and on and on and on, and they never break down. You just change the charcoal filter and that's it. Very cheap and easy. Other distillers I've had, cheap imitation ones, For a start, they use more electric. They've got a higher voltage, so you're using more money in the end. And then after about a year, they start to do strange things, like you pour 4 liters of water in, but only get 1 liter out. It's like, where did the other 3 liters go? Just evaporating into the atmosphere or something? I even had one distiller start spewing water out of the electrics, out of the fan. Or they just don't switch on, who knows why. Ring, 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 ring for the next month. Ugh, grates on my nerves. Okay, so if you're new to the whole water distiller clean H2O concept and you don't have $100 or $200, $200 for the mega home, then what I recommend is just spend a few dollars. It would be like $7 a week. That's 1 gallon a day. And go to Walmart. If you're in England, it's a bit more tricky. It's more rare to find distilled water. But if you're in America, you can just pay $7 a week and just see how it tastes, see how it feels. Probably a lot of people, especially in America, they're buying bottled water anyway. They're buying spring water or, you know, they're buying something. So just switch to distilled. Don't buy spring water. It's dirty. It's from a dirty spring. It's sprung out of the dirty ground, run over a dirty mountain, picking up dirt. Minerals! It's got minerals! Yep, you can get all your minerals from food. It's not necessary to get your minerals dissolved in your water. Inorganic minerals that your body can't process. It's just the equivalent of sand in your gas tank. So, I know that was a very brief lesson on water distillers and clean water, but it's informative, useful information if you take action on it. I can't film and hold this because it hurts my thumbs, so I'd rather hold one in each hand. That means putting you guys down. My name's Seb, this is The Cam. Boom! This is Seb Cam. And check this out. I don't know which sleeve it was. I think it was this one. Anyway, it's all been fixed up, so no need for a new shirt, no need to rip it off. And I definitely won't pull any threads anymore. A little tip for anyone out there. If you see a thread on your clothes, just cut it with some scissors. Don't pull it like I did. It's a bad idea. Right, Labello just asked me, yo, you wanna go to the beach? And I was like, at first in my mind, I thought I've gotta edit, I've gotta do this, I've gotta do that, I need to prepare the hammock, I need to, there's all these things I gotta do. And I'm like, you know what? It's my rule, I say yes to everything. So I'm like, yes, I do want to go to the beach. And maybe we can go see Jack again, because he has a surprise for me. He sent me a message saying, hey, I've got something that will help your journey. How can I mail it to you? So I think, instead of him mailing it, we'll go pick it up. Got no idea what it is. About to find out.
Tonight, take an exclusive behind-the-scenes look at everyone's favorite TV series.
Seb Cam!
Yeah!